friends, welcome to my channel. Today's topic is very, very important for those students who are aiming for NEET. Because in NEET 2020, two image-based questions have been asked from this topic. One was herbs to plants. There was an image of herbs to plants, and the second image was from Frankel plants. So pay attention and revise this topic or study this topic very well. So now, any further ado, let's get started. This is an image of vestibular screen or oral screen. Now, where do we use vestibular screen? It is used for habit correction. These appliances are basically meant to interrupt mouth breathing habit. Indirectly, they can also be used for interception of thumb sucking, tongue thrusting, lip biting, etc. They can be used to perform muscle exercises. Mild class 2 malocclusions can be corrected using the vestibular screen. The vestibular screen can be used to retrocline mildly proclined anterior teeth. Now, this diagram is showing the mechanism of action of oral screen. In the region depicted as 1, the oral screen contacts the anterior teeth, and the lip pressure is transmitted through the oral screen to anterior teeth, and proclination gets corrected. In the region depicted as 2 is the molar or posterior region, where the buccinator mechanism is shielded away by oral screen. So the tongue pressure exerts outward thrust on the dentition from inside, expanding the arches. Here you can see Denholz appliance. Basically, it is lip bumper or lip plumber, but when it is given in upper arch, it is named as Denholz appliance. This is lower removable lip bumper. Guys, lip bumper can be of two types, removable or fixed type. So here in this image is lower removable lip bumper. And here is an image of lower fixed lip bumper. Now, where can we use lip bumper? They are used in patients exhibiting abnormal habits such as lower lip sucking. It is also indicated for alignment of lower anterior teeth. Lip bumpers can be used to augment anchorage. And for distalization appliance, the mandibular molars can be distalized by lip bumpers that incorporate spring or loop anterior to first molar. And they are also used as space regainers. This is an image of activator or Anderson appliance, monoblock or Norwegian appliance. All these names are for this single appliance, okay? So do keep in mind. Okay. Essentially, activator is a unified appliance of upper and lower Holly appliance. Lower appliance may or may not be containing labial bow, as you can see in the image, and retentive component is also optional. To remember the activator properly and to identify it into the image, you need to know the components of this appliance very well, okay? So here A is maxillary acrylic plate, B is your mandibular acrylic plate, C is the labial bow, and D is the acrylic bite joining upper and lower component. It is used for class 2 div 1 and div 2 malocclusion corrections. Okay, and it is also used for class 3 malocclusions and open bite malocclusion. This is the image of standard bionator appliance. Okay, there are three types of bionator: standard appliance, class 3 appliance, and the open bite appliance. So this is standard appliance bionator. This is the line diagram showing the wire components of bionator. Here you can study it better, okay? The one is labial or vestibular wire, which is of 0.9 mm. And the palatal arch, you can see, which is denoted by 2, it is of 1.2 mm. So this standard appliance is typically used for the treatment of class 2 div 1 and class 1 cases with narrow dental arches. This is class 3 appliance or reverse bionator. This is used in case of mandibular prognathism to encourage the development of maxilla. The acrylic parts are similar to standard appliance. The palatal bar configuration runs forward instead of posteriorly. Here, note the labial bow running on lower anteriors instead of upper anteriors. And here, notice this is the view from above, so note the reverse direction of the palatal loops. So this suggests reverse bionator. and this is open bite bionator, the labial wire crosses the interdental area. This is used in open bite cases and this is used to inhibit abnormal posture and function of the tongue. The palatal arch and the vestibular wires are same as the standard appliance. Indications of bionator are in class 2 Div 1 malocclusion. This is an image of Frankel appliance. Now the Frankel 1 is similar to Frankel 2 in all aspects except that it lacks the lingual shield, lingual springs, lingual crossover wire and the upper lingual bow seen in Frankel 2. So upper labial bow is specific component of Frankel 1 and 2. This is how you will differentiate it. This is the image of Frankel 3 appliance because there is labial bow in lower edge. So here the distracting forces on the upper lip are removed from the maxilla by the upper labial pads and the force of the upper lip is transmitted through the appliance to the mandible because of the close fit of the appliance to that arch. This is the image of Frankel 3 appliance where you can see upper labial pads, okay, and labial bow is in lower edge. This is the image of twin block appliance. I'm sorry guys, it is not that much clear, but I'll post another image as well. So here you can see the upper block from occlusal view and the lower block from the occlusal view. The upper appliance consists of a bite block that covers the lingual cusp of the upper posterior teeth. You can notice the dark pinkish area in the diagram and extending anteriorly till the mesial ridge of the upper second premolar or primary second molar, whichever is present. And the lower bite block extends distally up to the distal marginal ridge of the second premolar. The angle of inclination between the blocks should be 70 degrees, preferably for horizontal advancement. Here is the line diagram of twin block. You can appreciate the delta clasp, ball end clasp, upper block and the lower block. Primary indication for twin blocks in early mixed dentition is in class 2 Div 1. They can reduce overjet and correct distal occlusion. They can control overbite if overbite is deep or anterior open bite is present. They can improve arch form by transverse or sagittal development. This is the image of Herbst appliance. Treatment with Herbst may be completed within 6 to 9 months, thus it is possible to make use of the little residual growth left over in this patient considering the severity of malocclusion. It is aptly referred to as powerful class 2 corrector. Since the appliance is fixed and has the advantage of continuous wear of 24 hours a day, it can be bring changes within short time without much need of patient's cooperation. And it is effective in chronic snoring and mild to moderate obstructive sleep apnea syndrome. They are specifically indicated as an anterior repositioning splint in patient having temporomandibular joint disorders. Herbst can be of two type, bended Herbst and bonded Herbst. The bonded acrylic Herbst appliance in patient's mouth. And this is also image of Herbst appliance in which the expansion device has been applied along with the acrylic crown. Now this image resembles quite similarly with Herbst appliance, but it is Jasper jumper. Jasper jumper is a flexible open coil spring with polyurethane covering. Okay, here you can see the polyurethane covering and the end caps are attached to the fixed appliance at the maxillary posterior by a ball pin that passes through the face bow tube of the maxillary first molar. In mandibular anterior region, the module is anchored to the lower arch wire distal to the mandibular canine by a small bayonet bend and a Lexan bead. They are basically indicated in skeletal class 2 malocclusion with maxillary excess and mandibular deficiencies. Jasper jumper brings about both skeletal and dento-alveolar changes in the ratio of 40:60. So myofunctional appliances forms an important part of interceptive orthodontics and also very important for your image-based questions. I hope this video was useful to you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. And hey, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet.